अस्सलाम वालेकुम, माय नेम इज़ हसन बिन मुरी। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट रिच गॉट, इट्स फिजियोलॉजिकल डिसऑर्डर्स, इंसेक्ट पेस्ट डिजीज एंड देयर कंट्रोल मेजर्स एज असाइंड बाय डॉक्टर तनवीर अहमद, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ हॉर्टिकल्चर, एरिड एग्रीकल्चर यूनिवर्सिटी, रावलपिंडी। सो रिच गॉट विच इज़ नोन एज ल्यूफा एक्यूटेंगुला इन बोटानिकल वर्ल्ड, इट इज़ अ डार्क ग्रीन समर वेजिटेबल। It has white pulp with white seeds embedded in spongy flesh, which is commonly known as tori. Okay, let's discuss about the physiological disorders of rich gourd. It includes soil structure, soil pH, air pollution, and ozone layer. We will discuss some of them in details. Firstly, if we talk about the soil structure determines the soil's ability to hold water, nutrients and oxygen and make them available to the plants. The more good the soil structure is, the more good the crop will be. Well, the most common issue that is related to the soil structure is compaction. Compaction is the presence of soil particles close to each other, reducing the pore spaces for the root growth. Compaction can be occurred due to the many reasons, which includes traffic, which may be due to the construction equipment's raindrop impact with high intensity and tilling operations, etc. Another most common disorder of rich gourd is soil pH. Such a soil that has a pH below 5.5 generally results in low availability of calcium, magnesium and phosphorus and increase the solubility of elements like aluminium, iron and boron. High levels of these three nutrients in low soil pH are common and can induce toxicity symptoms in plants. Such plants that are grown in these alkaline soils often have deficiency symptoms to these nutrients. If you talk about the pests that attack rich gourd, it includes fruit fly and red pumpkin beetle. Fruit fly, it is one of the major pests that attack rich gourd. Adult fly has reddish brown body with transparent and shiny wings, and it lay eggs in clusters of 4 to 12 in flowers. While we can control this by covering the developing fruits with paper cover or with polythene sheet, or by collecting and destroying affected fruits by dipping in hot water. Another pest that attack Leufa acutangula is red pumpkin beetle. While beetle eat leaf lamina causing defoliation at cotyledon stage of crop, application of furadin is very useful in controlling this pest. If you talk about the insects that affect the rich gourd, it mainly includes aphid and leafhopper. While aphids suck sap from the leaves of rich gourd, which cause crinkling of leaves, we can control this by spraying malathion, etc. Another insect which is known as leaf hopper, it is a green color hopper and its hymph are seen in large number under the surface of leaves and suck sap, causing typical hopper burn symptoms. Spraying of acetaph is effective in controlling hopper. If you talk about the diseases of rich gourd, it mainly includes powdery mildew and downy mildew. Powdery mildew, it mainly affects the vegetable during the rain-free period. Symptoms appear as white to dirty gray spots or patches on leaves. Downy mildew, this disease is mainly caused in humid areas during rainy seasons. Symptoms appear as water-soaked lichens under surface of leaf lamina. Okay, that was all about rich gourd, its physiological disorders and the control measures that we can take to manage the insect, pest and disease attack. Thank you.